Hello scientific people, today we are going to discuss about a very important topic, that is Torricelli's barometer. This topic is mainly confused by most of the people, but I am attempting here to solve all of your doubts. But before we move on, there are few things that we must understand. So suppose a body is at a depth h inside the liquid. Suppose this is a liquid and this container is filled with liquid, and the pressure exerted by the liquid at the bottom is given by this expression, pressure is equal to h rho g. Now I am giving you two points. This is point A, this is point B. Now these two points are inside a same liquid, so pressure at A and pressure at B, the depth is measured from free surface, which is same for both. They are inside the same liquid, so rho is same for both. Of course g is also same for both, so pressure at A is equal to pressure at B. That's what is mentioned in point number two. Now here the Torricelli's barometer was designed by Evangelista Torricelli, and he made this barometer, and the use of barometer is to measure atmospheric pressure. So let's see how a barometer looks like. So here we have a 100 centimeter long test tube which is completely filled with mercury till top, and while we are filling this mercury, we make sure that there are no air bubbles inside. Very careful that if you fill this mercury till top and if there are air bubbles inside, it is going to spoil our experiment. So this is 100 centimeter long test tube, correct, and we have a container which is also filled with mercury. So both the test tube as well as a container, both are filled with mercury. This container is half filled with mercury. Now put your thumb gently on the top and invert this test tube over the surface of this mercury which is present inside this container. So you will see something like this. So this is the 100 centimeter long test tube which is being inverted over the mercury surface which is present in the container, correct. So now we have h, that is 100 centimeter. Some of our viewers might be having this doubt that how is this test tube standing on the surface of the mercury column. So we have placed a beehive shelf over here for the support, and you have to make the support such that this mouth of the test tube should not be blocked, right. So we may put something over here for the support, but we need not to show that right now. But there is a support over here, and we do not want this mouth of this test tube to get blocked. Now there are two points. This is point A and this is point B. So at point B, air is exerting pressure, and I am calling that pressure as PB. So air from the top is exerting the pressure at point B, and A is below 100 centimeters long mercury column. So pressure at A would be the pressure exerted by this mercury column at point A. Now pressure at A is larger than pressure at B, just accept it for a while. This is a practically observed fact that pressure at A is larger than pressure at B. And how do we know that? Since pressure at A is larger than pressure at B, so liquid, which is mercury, will flow from high pressure to low pressure. So the mercury will start coming out, and pressure at A can be calculated by h rho g, where h is 100 centimeter. So I am going to convert this into 1 meter. Density of mercury is 13600 kg per meter cube, multiply by 10 meter per second square. Now this pressure is the value of pressure at A, which is larger than the pressure at B, which I am asking you right now to accept it, because we see the mercury flowing out. So mercury flows from high pressure to low pressure, which confirms that pressure at A is larger than pressure at B. So as the mercury flows out, the height of the mercury column decreases, and finally the mercury column stops at 76 centimeters from the bottom of the test tube. So we see something like this. Finally, the mercury level stops at 76 centimeters from the bottom of the test tube. This is 76 centimeter, and these are our points, that are points A and B. Pressure exerted at B is PB. Now the pressure exerted at A is PA. This mercury height does not change. Now the mercury does not flow out, which means that pressure at A and pressure at B are same now, because when the pressures become equal, there is no net flow of liquid. So pressure at A is now equal to pressure at B. Pressure at B is atmospheric pressure. So atmospheric pressure is PB, whereas PA is equal to H rho G, where H is 76 centimeters. This is practically observed thing. So we can put a scale and measure this length. So this 76 centimeters is an experimental observation. So I am converting that into meters. Density of mercury is 13600 kg per meter cube, multiply by 10 meter per second square, or 9.8 meter per second square. This value roughly turns out to be 101,300 pascals, which can be also written as 101.3 kilopascals, which is the value of PB, because P and PB are same. So the atmospheric pressure can be calculated with the help of this experiment. So we have now found out the value of atmospheric pressure as 101.3 kilopascals. This atmospheric pressure is the pressure at sea levels, because we have carried out this experiment at sea level. Now, what if the length of the test tube is more than 100 centimeters? So we might again go to this calculation and say that the pressure exerted by 76 centimeters of mercury column balances the air pressure. So if you take a longer mercury column test tube over here, say for example this is 200 centimeters test tube. Now this is completely filled with mercury, and you are inverting it over the surface and doing the experiment again. So what is expected? Again, the mercury level will stop at 76 centimeters, because that is the only height which is going to balance the air pressure. So pressure at point A and pressure at point B will be only balanced by the mercury column of length 76 centimeters. So the torsionless vacuum which was created over here earlier was 24 centimeters. Now it will be 124 centimeters. So this part will be completely vacuum, and this will be now 124 centimeters of torsionless vacuum. So we might not get confused that the length of the test tube is going to spoil our experiment or change our experiment, right? So the pressure remains the same, external air pressure remaining the same. So only 76 centimeters mercury column is going to stay over here. Moving on, what if we take a broader test tube? So again, if we take a broader test tube, it is not going to affect our experiment, because only 76 centimeters of the mercury column is going to balance the air pressure. Now, many of our viewers might be thinking that, okay, that this is point A and this is point B, but now we have more weight of the mercury column above point A, so it should be, you know, different than the 76 centimeters. But I want to make a point over here that pressure at B is the atmospheric pressure, which is same 101.3 kilopascals, but the pressure over here is independent of the area and the weight, right? Because the pressure is equal to h rho g. So pressure at A would be equal to h rho g, which is equal to pressure at B, but liquid is not being changed, so density remains the same, g remains the same, atmospheric pressures remains the same, so h as per mathematical calculations remains 76 centimeters. Now you might be thinking that we are taking more weight of mercury, but anyhow, if the weight increases, then the area also is increasing, so weight upon area, the pressure remains the same, so it does not depend upon the amount of mercury that we are taking over here. So even if you take a broader test tube, the height of the mercury column remains 76 centimeter. What if I tilt this test tube? Again, I would like to make a point that when we talk about the height 76 centimeters mercury, it is the height from free surface to free surface. What does that mean? I am talking about this particular height. This is the free surface of mercury, which is in contact with the vacuum, and this is the another free surface of the mercury, and I am talking about the perpendicular distance between these two surfaces, like this. So free surface of mercury to free surface of mercury, perpendicular distance. So over here again, suppose this was the 76 centimeters marking, because this is the free surface of mercury to free surface of mercury. This is 76 centimeters. So again, this free surface to free surface will not change. So what is going to happen? The mercury level will be filled till here. Here the mercury level will be filled till here. So we may say that compared to this test tube, let us call this test tube as A, this as B, this is C. So compared to A, B has got larger volume of mercury, because the mercury has to rise up in order to make this height as 76 centimeters, right? And comparatively, C has got the largest volume of mercury. I'm talking about volume, but this height remains 76 centimeters. So no effect of tilting of mercury on the test tubes. So the perpendicular height from free surface to free surface remains the same, but the volume of course would be larger if you tilt it to a more extent. If we use water instead of mercury, then what do you expect? Pressure exerted at point B is the atmospheric pressure, which is 101.3 kilopascals. That is being balanced by the air pressure, sorry, that is being balanced by the pressure exerted by the liquid column in the mercury, sorry, in the test tube. This is point A. So this PA is written as H rho G. Now rho is now decreased from 13600 to only 1000 kg per meter cube. So since mercury was a very heavy liquid, mercury has got density 13600 kg per meter cube. Now water has got density only 1000 kg per meter cube, so there is a great reduction in the density. G remains the same, so PB remains the same, so 101.3 kilopascal has to be balanced by H times, now the new rho is 1000 kg per meter cube, G is 10 meter per second square. So this is not changing, this is not changing, there is a great reduction in this. So in order to make the product equal to this, height must go up, and if you calculate this, you will get your answer roughly as 10.8 meter. That means now the pressure, air pressure, that is the pressure exerted by the air at point B is balanced by a very long column of water that is 10.8 meter approximately. So you have to make a very long test tube or a very long barometer if you are using water. Anyhow, water boils off at 100 degree, so it is very difficult to use water above 100 degrees, and water is anyhow transparent, so it is difficult to see the rise and fall in the water level. If you have not understood by this mathematical calculations, I am going to explain you with the another example. So let's move on. So here is the atmospheric pressure, that is the pressure exerted by the air, that is PB, and that is 101.3 kilopascal. Now at this particular point, that is, I am keeping 76 centimeters long mercury column. So this is 76 centimeter mercury column. Now mercury is a very heavy liquid, so heavy liquid is balancing this air pressure. But now if I remove this mercury column and if I put a very lighter liquid, so I'll have to take larger in height. So if I take water, water being very light, I'll have to take a longer water column, so I would be needing 10.8 meters long mercury column. So heavy liquids, smaller height is required, whereas lighter liquids would be requiring comparatively very large height, like barometer size increases. What if I take different shapes of container, and like again the mercury is filled till here, again the shape of the container does not affect our experiment. I have already told you that if this is mercury, if say for example this is mercury over here, and in all these three containers we are filling mercury, then the perpendicular distance between free surface to free surfaces remain the same. So the mercury will be filled till here, mercury will be filled till here, till here, but the volume of mercury will differ in all three, but the perpendicular height is going to remain the same. It is not going to affect our experiment, correct? So let's move on. Here we have a Mount Everest, and suppose we are moving with a barometer to the Mount Everest. So at Mount Everest the air pressure PB is very less, so it is approximately 30% of 101.3 kilopascal. So there is a great reduction in the air pressure. So if I make this arrangement again, so here the pressure decreases. So comparatively, 76 centimeters mercury column was exerting pressure equal to PB pressure. Now if this PB pressure falls, so this must also fall. So PA is equal to H rho G. No change in G, almost no change in rho. So if there is a fall in PB, so there must be a fall in PA. So H also reduces. So the mercury comes out, and finally the mercury would be settling at some height which is less than 76 centimeters. If you go inside the, say for example, sea at a very large depth, and if you go with the same barometer, then what is going to happen is, since the pressure inside the sea is very large, so PB would be comparatively, so let me write it down actually, PB is now very large than 101.3 kilopascal. So comparatively, in order to equalize PB, PA also has to increase. PA is equal to H rho G. No change in the density of the liquid, we are not changing the mercury. G is not reduced. So if PA increases, H also has to increase. So if you are going with a barometer inside the sea, the level of mercury will increase in order to balance this pressure PB, this height H, this height H will be larger than 76 centimeter. So this is what is going to happen. So guys, my initiative to talk about the barometer, I think that I have made you explain in a very simple version. If you have any doubts, please do comment in the comment section. And if you have not subscribed my channel, do subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching the video.